Hi everyone, today I'll be showing you how to create the digital doodle with Generative AI or Gen AI digital doodle app with App Inventor. Before we get started, let's take a look at the finished product. Here we can see up top there's a label, then text box, a button. This here in the middle is a canvas. We have four more buttons to change color here and a slider at the bottom. So we can draw with change the color by selecting the buttons, use the slider to change the width of the color. And then there's an accelerometer so we can shake and it'll erase. And finally, we can type in a prompt that will go to a generative AI source and create an image for us. So let's do something like beach sunset. Hit generate image. You can see down here at the bottom, there's a notifier that is telling us that an image is being generated. And then now we have our image that our user can still draw on. So let's get started. To begin, select new project in the top left corner and name your project Gen AI Digital Doodle. Then select OK. This will bring you to the designer page. Over here on the left, we can see our components, on the right, the properties, and in the middle, the screen where we'll build our app. So let's start by closing the inner interface drawer and opening drawing and animation. Drag and drop a canvas onto your screen. Then in the properties, let's change its height to fill parent and the width to fill parent. Now we can go to the top right corner, select blocks. This is the block screen, which is where we will code the functionality of our app. Begin by clicking canvas and then dragging and dropping whencanvas1.dragged into your workspace. Then what we want to do is go back under canvas and choose draw a line and drag and drop. We're going to use draw a line because any curve can be approximated by a series of small lines connected together. Then to get our x1, y1, and x2, y2 coordinates, we're going to hover over prevx and use get prevx, hover over prevy, get prevy, and then do the same with current x and current y. Now we can already start to test our app. Open up the MIT App Inventor app on your mobile device and select connect at the top of your screen an AI companion. A QR code will appear, and you can scan the QR code with your mobile device. Now, let's see what our app can do already. So, now we can draw on our app, but notice we're lacking a lot of functionality we had before. We can't change the color, we can't change the size, we can't generate a background, and we can't erase. The reason we want to use prevx and prevy instead of start x and start y is that start x and start y remember the very first place the user touched the canvas. So don't do this, but I will show you what it looks like when you use start x and start y. I'm going to refresh my connection. This is what it looks like when you use start x and start y instead of prevx and prevy. It shows that sometimes in computer science, small mistakes can lead to beautiful things. So let me change back to prevx and prevy, and then we'll continue. Click designer to return to the designer screen. Now that we're back in designer, the next thing we want to add is an accelerometer so that we can erase our drawings. So close the drawing and animation drawer and go under sensors. There we can find the accelerometer and drag and drop it onto your screen. An accelerometer is a non-visible component, so it'll appear below your screen here. Let's return to blocks. Now that we're back in blocks, let's code the functionality of our accelerometer. Go under accelerometer and select the when accelerometer sensored one dot shaking block. Then we want our canvas to erase, so we'll call canvas1.clear. Let's test now. So So now I can draw, and when I shake my device, it erases. Perfect. Let's return to Designer. The next piece of our app that we're going to add is our colored buttons. So let's close the sensors drawer, open layout, and choose a horizontal arrangement. We're going to set the width to fill parent and select OK. Next, we're going to close our layout drawer and open the user interface drawer. We're going to drag and drop a button into our horizontal arrangement. Let's start by renaming this button Black Button and click OK. We want to rename every component so that we know what the components do. We named it Black Button because it is going to be the black color, and Button because we want to keep the component name in its name. Then we're going to set the background color of Black Button to black. We're going to set the width to 20% because we're going to put four buttons in there and we want to create some space between them. And we're going to set the text to black and the text color to yellow so that stands out. Then you can click on this button and using Control-C, Control-V on Windows, you can make a copy of the button. Then we're going to rename this button Red Button. I'm going to change the background color to red and the text to red. However, since we copied the button, you'll note that we did not have to change the width or the text color. Let's copy and paste for the rest of our buttons. So I want a blue button, which I'm going to make blue and make sure the text is blue. And then I'm going to make a green button. Make sure the text says green and that the background is green. Then notice how our buttons are not centered. We can go under horizontal arrangement and select and set the align horizontal to center. Now let's go to blocks and code the functionality of our buttons. Now that we're in blocks, let's begin by going under black button and choosing whenBlackButton.click. Then what we want to do is go under canvas and find the setter for paint color. We're going to set canvas1.paintColor2, and then under these built-ins, we're going to find colors and we'll drag and drop black. Then we can either right click and choose duplicate and then use the drop down menu to change the color and the color there. I don't like that color. Or we can also Control C, Control V on a Windows, the code block, and then use the drop down to change. And then one last one, we're going to do is we need to set our red button to red. Okay, let's return to Designer. Now let's test this out. If I draw in black, then if I select red, now the user has the ability to change the color of their ink. Perfect. Now, let's add a slider. Under the user interface, we can find a slider which we can drag and drop below our horizontal arrangement. We want to set our width to fill parent. We want to set the max value to 100. We want to set the min value to 5. And we want to set the thumb position to 10. Now let's go to blocks. Now that we're in blocks, let's code the functionality of our slider. We want to begin by going under canvas and finding the set line width block. Then we're going to go to slider and find slider1.thumbposition and click it there. And then I'm going to move this block up just a little to give me space. And we want this to be the first thing that happens when canvas one is dragged. Now let's return to Designer. Let's test the functionality of our slider. Now you can see that we have our slider at the bottom. So if I draw, I can then change the width of my lines. And this change in width holds true as I change my colors as well. And then we can still erase. Perfect. Now it's time to add the final part. Let's begin by taking a label and dragging and dropping it above our canvas. Now that we've dragged and dropped our label, we can see that it's not centered. So we'll go to screen one and choose align horizontal to be center. Let's return to our label. We can leave it at this size, but for our text, we're going to say type in your background. After we center our label, the next thing we're going to want to get is a text box. We're going to drag and drop the text box beneath our label, and we're going to rename it Gen AI Text Box. Click OK. Then we're going to set its width to fill parent. Below our text box, we're going to get a button, and we're going to also rename this Gen AI Button. Then what we want to do is change its background color to orange. We're going to make its shape rounded, and we want the text to read Generate Background. Now, the last thing we need before we can code the functionality is we need the image bot. So let's close the user interface drawer and go under experimental. There you can find the image bot, drag and drop it onto your screen. The image bot is a non-visible component and will appear alongside the accelerometer at the bottom of your screen. You will need an API key to use your image bot for multiple prompts. Go to blocks. Now let's code the functionality of our image bot. Begin by selecting the Gen AI button and drag and dropping the When Gen AI button dot clicked block onto your screen. Then we want to go under ImageBot and call ImageBot.createImageDescription. The description for our ImageBot is going to be our GenAiTextBox.text, which you can find here. Then we're going to go back under ImageBot and choose the WhenImageBot1.ImageCreated. What we want to do then is set the canvas background to that image. So we're going to find set canvas1.background image, and we can delete this no available assets. And then we're going to hover over file name and select the get file name block and place it there. Now let's test this. I'm going to choose a prompt. This time I'll do flowers. And select generate background. Right now, I'm waiting, but I don't know if the image bot is generating anything for me. Some users might begin to spam the generate background button, but it was working. And here's our background, so we can draw on it. The reason for this delay is that the prompt that the user has sent in must travel to OpenAI, where an image is generated, and then that image must travel back to App Inventor, where it then appears in our canvas. So, to solve this confusion that a user may feel, let's add a notifier. Let's close the experimental drawer and go under user interface. Here's a notifier and drag and drop it onto your screen. It is also a non-visible component and will appear below. Now let's go to blocks and code its functionality. Now that we're in blocks, let's code the functionality of our notifier. Let's go under notifier and select show progress dialog. This is what we want to do when we click the Gen AI button as the very first thing. So let's create some space. For our message, we're going to go under text and choose an empty text box. Our message is going to say generating image. And the title that we'll put will also be an empty text box, and we'll type in, please wait. Now when the user presses the generate background button, they will get a notifier. in order to, but we need to dismiss this notification once we get an image. So let's go back under notifier and do call notifier one dot dismiss progress dialog and place it as the first block under when image bot dot image create. Let's return to designer so we can test our app. All right, let's see what it looks like now with a notifier. I'm going to choose a different prompt this time, like jungle with a view. Notice how now we have a notifier telling us that an image is being generated. This will help users understand what is going on. And here's our jungle. And now the user can draw, change color, change width, and even generate more backgrounds. Congratulations, you have now completed the GenAI Digital Doodle app with MIT App Inventor. Here are some ideas for how you can expand your app. You can add more colors. You could allow users to draw dots as well. You can develop the capability to erase specific parts of a doodle. You can create a list of preset background ideas that a user can choose from. You can try to create a collection of doodled images and form a class gallery. You could organize an image doodle competition. See what other ideas you can come up with. Congratulations, and we can't wait to see what you do next.